Hi everyone, Greg Meskel here for LakersNation.com. Back when I was busy getting cut from my high school basketball team on two separate but awesome occasions, something I always worked on was the Mikan drill. For those that don't know how it works, you camp out under the basket and work on making layups with each hand on each side of the hoop. The Mikan drill is of course named after George Mikan, an all-time Lakers great and the original center, who played his entire career in the NBA with the Minneapolis Lakers. He never got to experience LA on the court, but his name is rightfully in the rafters of the Staples Center. Now we honor Mikan, aka Mr. Basketball, with a look at his top five all-time moments. At number five comes Mikan's impact on the rules. At 6 foot 10 inches and 245 pounds, today George Mikan will be an average power forward. But in the 1940s and 50s, this guy was gigantic. He was so big, two famous rules were created to control Mikan. Mikan would routinely goaltend the ball, leading to, as you might guess, the goaltending rule. It's hard to believe, but before Mikan, tall players weren't really part of the game, so people taking the ball off the rim wasn't a concern. Mikan was also so big, it was ruled the lane had to be widened from 6 feet to 12 feet to control Mikan's impact on offense, now known as the Mikan rule. Nothing speaks to dominance quite like rule changes with your name attached. In at number 4 comes a moment you won't believe. Before the days of the shot clock, a team could hold the ball as long as they liked. The Fort Wayne Pistons did exactly this against the Lakers in the 1950-51 season to keep the ball from the dominant Mikan. The Pistons won 19-18, but Mikan scored 15 of those points, giving him the highest percentage of team points scored by a single player ever at 83%. Trust me, this is never happening again. That season, Mikan averaged a career-best 28.4 points per game. To number 3 we go in the 1953-54 season, where a 29-year-old Mikan guided the Lakers to their third straight league title and fifth in the previous 6 years. Mikan would retire prematurely following the season, and he averaged 18.1 points per game and 14.3 rebounds. The title cemented Mikan's legacy as the best player of his era. He returned in the 55-56 season, helping the Lakers to clinch a playoff berth, and then retired for good. In at number 2 is a memorable performance from Mikan in 1949. Before joining the NBA, the Lakers competed in the BAA, the Basketball Association of America, and Mikan led the team to a championship victory over Washington. In Game 5, Mikan, battling a broken wrist and wearing a cast, scored 22 points. Despite a loss in that game, Mikan and the Lakers came back to win the series in Game 6 with a 77-56 win. Mikan averaged a ridiculous 30.3 points per game during that playoff run.
And here come the Lakers.
At number 1 comes Mikan's introduction to the NBA. The start of the new league in the 1949-50 season saw Mikan and the Lakers dominate. Mikan averaged 27.4 points per game and leading the Lakers to a 51-17 regular season record. In the 1950 NBA Finals, Mikan powered the Lakers to a 6-game victory over the Syracuse Nationals for their first ever NBA crown. His 31.3 points per game average in the playoffs carried the Lakers. So there you have it, a look at one of the all-time Lakers greats. For his efforts, Mikan was inducted into the first ever class of the NBA Hall of Fame and was selected as one of the NBA's 50 greatest players ever in 1996. So how many of you knew all of that about George Mikan? More importantly, when are you going to start working on the Mikan drill? Let us know down in the comments or tweet at us at Lakers Nation.